Fenway Park, Boston. For the tortured fans of the Boston Red Sox, it's a day they thought might never come. The first World Series title in 86 years. As the party rages outside the stadium, Yali Sharon climbs up to a windowsill to record the craziness.
Everyone was just so excited. There was fireworks going off. It was complete joy.
But Red Sox Nation has its share of lunatics. And complete joy is about to give way to total mayhem.
The energy was just so over the top. People started acting in ways that they kind of forgot about their own safety.
The streetlight becomes a popular place for crowd diving. But it only takes an impromptu bonfire to distract people from cushioning a comrade.
He slipped, and the crowd was not ready to catch him. He wound up just slamming onto the ground.
Police have seen enough. They have to clear the area before someone gets killed.
They started throwing tear gas and noise-making grenades. And then they came in with motorcycles, with all riot police wearing gas masks. It basically felt like a war zone.
It's an overwhelming show of force. And it does the trick. The rioters are chased from the streets, putting the champagne on ice and quelling the destruction. For many Bo Sox supporters, this championship was something they thought they might not live to see. But when unbridled enthusiasm became reckless endangerment, it was up to cops to make sure they lived to see tomorrow.